very, very important question. Focus. In the last class, we have generated the LO data source, replicated and connected to the target bus. Now the entire flow in my PW is ready now. If you see display data flow, so I've got source, data source, and connected target with the help of transformations, and I also have the runtime objects of DTP and what? Info package. Everything is ready. My flow is ready, but I have not triggered any load yet. Okay. So once the data flow is ready, how do we start loading in LO extractor? That is very, very important. Now look at this. Focus, okay. So in BW you have a queue and you would like to extract all the dates. Which data source are we using? This? QLIS_11VHDR. Now what data is extracted from this data source? Sales orders. 11 indicates sales order and HDR indicates center level data. Okay. Now focus. Now you see what is your target? Whatever the historical data which is already posted, I would like to bring them through initialization. From then onwards, what are the records they post, I would like to bring them through what? Delta. Adina, that's important. Okay. Now look at this. Now where is all my sales data bus? Will that be in the standard tables? Yes or no? In VBAC, all the standard tables, you'll have all your sales orders available. Yeah. And how are the sales orders created into this table? When the end user does a posting into this T codes, VA01, he actually creates a new order into those tables. Yes or no? Now from this table, I would like to extract all the historical data into my BW through what? Init. From then onwards, what are the data they do posting, I need to bring them through what? Delta. That is my focus. Okay, that is what we call it, initializing the extractors. Clear this? See, how do we do this? Did you get this, what I am saying? So all the flow is, entire data flow is ready. Now you are supposed to extract all the historical data into BW through init, through initialization, and from then onwards, what are the new postings are done, we will have to extract them through what? Delta. Okay, boss? Now look at this. Let's say we have 100 sales orders historical already, means let's say before PW ECC was live, say 2 years back, and from 2 years they've been doing lot of postings on the sales orders. So from 2 years they create 100 sales orders. I would extract all these 100 into PW through init. From then onwards, what are the new sales orders they create, I must bring them through what? Delta. That is required. Clear? Now look at this. When I am extracting these 100 records to BW, if someone does any of the posting or they change an existing order, will I miss those changes? Yes or no? Only after initialization I am ready to capture those Delta records. Before it is done, if they do some postings during the initialization, I am going to miss those changes. Right? So what we would do is, see, in the real time, sales order can be created either from this VA01 or something, or they might be coming from other systems also. Means, let's say you have ECC, you have another non-SAP system, they create a sales order. Through IDOC, it posts a sales order automatically into ECC. It could have scenario like this also. So basically, you can think of two scenarios. One is from the T code, they create a sales order, or if it is coming from different applications, there will be some background job or some IDOC job comes and posts a transaction into ECC automatically. Even there is a possibility like that. Okay. Now what I want is, when I am initializing, when I am extracting all the historical data from ECC to BW, I don't want anyone to post a transaction at all. I don't want any new sales order to be created during that time. So what I do? I would consider during offline hours of the business, let's say during Saturday and Sunday, my business is off, let's say. So I would do installation during that time. Okay, so what we would generally do is, in the real time, we would communicate to the business bus during say 20, 30th and May 1st, May 2nd, May 3rd, these 3 days there will be no postings can be done, all the users will be logged, no transactions can be done. If there is anything, please finish off your work before that. And during May 1st, May 2nd, May 3rd, we schedule the downtime, which is a planned downtime, where all the users will be logged. And even all the jobs which is going to create a transaction, even jobs will be stopped. If there are some jobs which is going to create sales orders, even those jobs also will be stopped. And there will be nothing in the system. All the users are, that is what we call it as downtime. So ECG system is down. At all, they cannot access the system, they cannot do any postings. Completely ECG system will be down. They will not be able to access that system at all. That is what we call it as downtime. Okay. So what I will do is we will schedule the downtime and then start performing these activities. We call them as cut-over activities at all. Generally, in the real time, when you move these objects to production, in the real production environment, you have to initialize, you do all these steps of initializing everything. Because if you are extracting from development ECC to development BW or quality ECC to quality BW, you don't have to really worry about missing transactions. But only if it is in production, you will be really mainly worried on. So when you move these objects to production, the complete data flow to production, we call them as, we are performing cut-over activities. During this cut-over activities, we schedule the downtime. And what do we do during this cut-over act? How do we initialize that extractor? This is what we'll have to discuss. Okay, boss? Now look at this. See, my target is within these 3 days, May 1st, May 2nd, May 3rd, I need to bring in all the historical data. From May 4th, I must start doing what? Delta. That's my target. So if I need to do delta, do I need to do initialize? When I do full upload or initialize upload, where is the data coming from? It actually extracts data from something called SERP table, not from the database table. But where is actual sales orders? Where are your all the sales orders? In the database tables. But when you do initialization, where does data come from? SERP tables. But why, what, we'll discuss later. But just understand the steps now, okay? So then what I do? If I need to do delta, I need to do init. If I need to initialize, first before I do initialize, I need to fill the data in what? SERP table. Where is my actual data present in? Database tables. Now when I am extracting data from this database table and updating my SERP tables, I don't want anyone to do postings. For how do we handle that? Downtime. We schedule the downtime, all the users are logged, no one will be able to log into the system at all. 10 days or 1 month before we will announce it, so that they can finish all their activities before that day. And once the day comes in, no one will be able to log in at all. Okay. So now everyone is logged, all the jobs are stopped. So there can be no new postings available in the table or into the sales order. Generally what we do is, let's say now the downtime starts at say evening 6 o'clock. What we do is, we go to VBAC table and see the count, how many are there. Let's say there are 100 now. We'll wait for 1 hour and still see whether after 1 hour we again check the count. We see 100, it's fine. But if we see there is some difference in the count, means there is some entries coming in, and we would communicate to the basis and ask them to stop all the jobs and find out how it is coming, and we kill all those jobs. In SM37, you can see the job log and ask them to stop those jobs also. Okay. So now, after 2 hours, I have confirmed that there will be no new entries into this table. Then what we will do is, we will run something called, what is this here? Statistical setup. It's actually run, we run a statistical setup run and then extract all the records from these tables and load into what? SERP tables. And then once the data is filled into SERP tables, when you do an initialization, the records are brought into what? BW. Once my initialization is done, do you get to see your data source in Delta Q, like generic Delta? Once the init is successful, you'll start seeing your data source in what? In Delta Q. Means if it is in red, Delta Q means what? It is ready to capture those delta changes. Now once init is done and your data source is available in Delta Q to capture your delta records, we'll release the logs. Let's say now we are done by May 3rd, because you'll have many records, so it takes a lot of time. Okay. So let's say by May 3rd night we are done. we'll remove the downtime, we'll announce them, now same system is open, you can start working as it is now. Now from May 4th, you start, you see users doing lot of postings again, and all those postings should be what? Delta based. Since my data source is already ready in Delta Q to capture those Delta records, all the new postings will be collected as Delta records. And then in BW periodically, when you keep performing Delta, it extracts from where? From Delta Q to what? To BW. So this is what happens. If you remember other day when I was generating your LO data source, which update mode did I use? Direct Delta. This is what, how the data is extracted if it is direct Delta. See, if it is serial V3, it is different. Unserial V3, it is different. Queued disk at Okodan go different. Now we are focusing on Delta update. Sorry, direct Delta. Okay. Clear on this bus? Did you understand about steps now? We will discuss on later why, what, how. Okay. So now what I am trying to do is, there is nothing in this. So just the flow is formed. Let's say we have scheduled downtime, we have taken the help of various people, and then we have logged. This is where they can basically log, don't worry. They log all the T codes and users, everything is logged. And only you will be allowed for access, except you or the people who are going to do cutover activities will be allowed into the system. Yeah. And we take care of all this only when you are doing in production environment. Okay. I will discuss on that later. Clear? Now I am going to start now. What I do is, once it is scheduled downtime and there no, once I confirm that there are no new postings, first I need to fill data from this table to this table, right? But before I fill in, I want to make sure there is no content in this table. So if it is there, it keeps adding it up. Let's say someone already filled in for some reason, and then if I again load it, it goes and adds up. It becomes double. So to be on the safer side, what I'll do, I'll clean up this content in several tables. So first step, what I'm doing is delete the content of several tables. We use a T code LBWG for it. Okay. Now you want to delete the serif tables for it. What does it ask you? Application. Now you're dealing with which application data source? 11. So you're dealing with data of what? 11 application. So when you're deleting the serif tables, does it ask you which application or which data source? Does it ask me application number? When I say delete the serif tables, does it ask me data source name or application number? So can you understand with this saying, when I give application, it is going to delete serif tables for all the data source relevant to application what? 11. Whether header, item, everything is deleted for application 11. Yeah. So yes. Okay, boss. Remember this point, I'll come to that now. What is the next step was? Now we'll have to fill the data from database tables to what? Serif tables. There's no fixed T code for it, so you go to T code SBIW and settings for application specific data sources. Then what? Manage extract structures, initializations, filling in the serif tables. Application specific setup of statistical data for inventory management purchase. For each function area, you'll have different menu bus. So do you want to perform setup for inventory or purchasing or production, QM, plant material, service management, sales orders, deliveries, billing, which one you want? Sales order. Now get into this. Yeah. Now this is a screen where you basically perform your setup for sales. Now this is like selections. Look, this is, you can understand this like data selections of your info. If I say sales org gets 1000 and execute, then what happens? It extracts only of data for what? From database tables, it will fill serif tables only for records of sales org what? 1000. Same like this, you can give selections here. I can also pass selections for document number also. Generally it takes a lot of time. I don't want to spend so much time. What I'm trying to do is, I'm just giving selections only for this. Let me just pick up only this database. in real time, you don't give, you try to extract all the database. Yeah? It will run for 16 hours, 18 hours. The job of statistical setup with 2 years or 3 years of data runs for 16 hours, 18 hours run out. Only this job. So, okay. Then just give some name of the job. Something. And then specify the date and time of termination. Because this can't go on running. Because I have till time May 3rd. So, what I'll do, I'll just give May 3rd last time till when it can run max. After that, it has to stop. So yeah. But for me, I don't want anyone to stop. So, I'm just giving complete year. Okay. Then you can give fault tolerance limit. Like say, normally when you're doing setup tables, you might have some errors also. So if there's some failure, let's say it has brought in millions of data and then last with one record it has failed. Then we're going to miss out the time completely. Normally we give tolerance limit of in multiples of 100, 10, 100, thousands. We give tolerance means until 1000 records or 100 records, it should be able to tolerate those errors. If it is 100 records, we'll handle it later. Don't worry on that. Yeah. Something like that. And then if you want to simulate, you can select this. I'm not simulating, I want to physically load. If execute, this is foreground, but I want to do it in the background. Say what, execute in background LP01. When do you want to run? Immediate, and you run that as a job. What is the job name? RMC VNEUA. So you can check the job status in SM37. What is job status? What? Active is what job is running. So in the real time, you just check, take care of this job and keeps running and you keep observing for 16 hours, 18 hours. That's it. You hold it back and then keep observing the status of the job. So we'll wait until this is done and then. So job is done. Okay. So now should the data be filled in setup tables now? Can I check the data in the setup tables? Yes. But you cannot understand the data, but look at this. You go to SC11. So the name of the setup table, like it will be for each level, data source, you'll have one setup table naming. It's like this MC11 VA0HDR. This is your what? Extract structure name and the word setup. Are into kalupte setup table name of them. Okay. Display contents. How many are there? Why only 9? Why not? When you see that, you don't understand this. This is a, what is this? It says cluster. We will discuss on that later. But you can see number of entries. What is my next step telling me? Now the data is filled in a setup table. Then what should I do? Get back to BW, schedule the init load. Now, yeah? Now before running init load, you should observe that in RSS7, do you see your data source? 11 on the. Do we have 11 data sources? No. After running initialization, then you will start seeing your data source in what? Delta. What is it? Init? Init with the data. So, how many records will it extract now? Because when you do init, it has to bring data from setup tables. There are 9 records into it. Say start. So since you're doing initialization, it's about bringing historical 9 records and enabling your data source for delta in where? In delta Q, RSS7. Okay, 9 records are loaded. Now, should I run the DDP to load it to my queue? So 9 records are loaded to my queue. Okay, boss. Done. This is the value of these orders. Okay, boss. So this is done. Now, if it is inflation is done, now should I start seeing my data source in the delta Q? Do you get to see your data? Now, your data source is ready to capture your delta records. Clear? Okay. So what I would do is now focus on this delta records. Now let's say I release the logs. Now the day May 4th and all the users have come in, they start posting their transactions now. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to go to VA02. What is VA02? Changing of the sales order. Say I'll change this 7723. So 1966. I'm changing order quantity. Remember, I changed the document 7723. Yeah. Seven. Okay, then I want to create one new record also. I'll go to VA01. Order, I'll say 7722. I'm just creating a copy of an existing order. Just type OR and say copy with reference. I'm okay. Just change this. It's what, 754. This will give you the name of the number of the new sales order which is created. 14388. This is the new order. Now if I go to VA, where do you see delta? Now should that delta records be collected in RSS7? So for every new postings the user does like this, it will be collecting those postings into what? Delta Q. Now look at this. 2LIS_11VHDL says what? 200, it's not 2 records, 2 LUWs, logical unit of work. Okay. 2 indicates 2 LUWs. For every change of a record, it collects, for every change or creating a new record, it forms one LUW. But the LUW formed when you change an existing record will have 2 records in it. One is before image and after image. But the when it does the posting of creation of new order, it will have only one record as new image. But what is change log later on to that one? Then records chudachu, go in. I want to say delta update records 7723 x before, 7723 what after, and 14388 one record. That so actually it says 2 records, right? Records any records 3, so that two indicates it's not records, it is LUW space. So 7723 before and after together is one LUW. And 14388 is one LUW. So you got 2 LUWs into delta Q. Clear this? And you can see the values. 1966 before, 23 after, and 754 is a new record. Clear? Now when I do delta, will these three records come into BW bus? And one more point I want to show you, look at this. Now when you see data, you have two options here. Delta and what is this here? The same three records you see in delta repetition also. I will tell you why it is later. Okay, I will explain. Understand what are the three records? You have got in two sets. One is delta and what is delta repetition. Now let me go back to BW. Can I run delta now? How many records are expected? Three records. Now you see, I know this is not coming as negative. The other day also I forgot. I'll handle this. Is the small checkbox we can handle. Don't worry on this. So this is the first record, the before and after. This is before and this is after. And 1438 new record is also coming. Clear on this bus? It's a delta record, so sign. Okay. Now once the delta records are brought in, but if you see the delta queue. Munda 2 in the but now what does it say? Still say 2. Still 2. Why still 2? Look at this. Display contains delta update nothing. But delta repetition still you will have those 3 records. So, but does it still tell you 2? What does this 2 count indicate? 2 indicates 2 LUWs. Either in delta or delta repetition or in both. 2 indicates 2 LUWs available only in delta or only in delta repetition or in both. Renditlo unnar, ote lekkes kundundi. Yeh kudanlo unna, ote lekkes kundundi. So now that when still it is showing 2 because I don't have interest in delta but still there are entries in what? Delta repetition. It does hold the copy of those entries in delta repetition until the next delta is successful because the delta repetition set copy is still there to handle your delta failures. For example, if delta load has failed, I need to have someone who can just give me the same delta record again. For that, for safety, they hold the delta repetition set like that. Out, when do they understand the present delta? Normally, if delta is successful, you run delta. If delta fails, you run repeat delta, right? So, when delta fails, when you run repeat delta, this delta repetition images will go. Then this delta repetition delta records will be brought to BW. So to handle those delta load failures, your delta queue will maintain two sets of data. One is delta and what? Delta repetition. And even after, when you do delta, it takes records from delta and goes on. And delta is cleaned up. But delta repetition still holds until next delta is successful. Next delta success I work at level 20. To prove that what I will do, in BW, I know there are no new postings. Yes or no? There are no new postings, right? But I'm just running normal delta. Just to show you that delta repeat is cleaned up. Yeah. Did you run delta or delta repetition now? Delta. If you run delta now, it is understood that the previous delta was successful. Now delta fail, then you repeat. Normally when delta fails, you run repeat delta. If delta is successful, you just run normal next delta. So, since you are a normal next delta system understands that the previous delta was successful and now it cleans the delta repetition. What does it say? Since you have done second delta, it understands the previous delta was successful. The entries of previous delta was cleaned up from delta queue also. Until you run the next delta, it still holds those images like that. Okay. Arthamaindanna? Now let me do some posting now. There is 3000 something, someone is changing it. Now in delta Q, how many interests, how many LWs will you see? 2. But when it comes to records, how many records will you see? 4 or 3? 4. 2 changes, so 2 LWs. 1438 before after, 1724 before after. And do you see the same set of records even in delta repetition also? Yes or no? Yeah? Now in BW, I will go and run my delta load. How many records will you get? 4. But when you go to delta Q, will you see any records in delta update? No. But you still see the entries in delta repetition? Yes? Let me do another post. So I've done another posting now. That's a 3 records now. How many records in delta update now? Tell me. How many records? LW is 1, but records is what? 2. Before, after, 7725. And how many entries in delta repetition? 4 or 6? 6. Because normally when delta fails, you run repeat delta, which has to bring in present delta records plus previous also. So both it will have. All the 6. Now let us assume this delta load what has brought in 4 records has failed. Then what do you do? What do you do? You set this as red. Okay. And then set that as red and then delete your bad request. Even though it is red, you still set it red again. Yeah? And delete your bad request. So previous delta was failed, right? You still enable delta and running it. It will ask you. Once previous delta was failed, do you want request again? So this will run what? Repeat delta, yeah? So now when you say repeat delta, it should start fetching records from where? Repeat delta, which will bring in present delta record, which is 7725 before after, and previous delta records, which is 7724 and 14388 also. Yeah, you got 6 records. But this delta is cleaned up, okay? But delta repeat 6 records will be still there in the system until the next delta is successful. Inga malli assumes if delta repeat also has failed, then how to handle that? Inga atle pettukuntunnanu. So let's say now previous delta was successful, I run normal delta again. I know 0 records, but still successful, right? Now how many records? 0. This is how your delta Q will handle 2 sets, delta and delta repetition, to handle your delta load failures. Okay. So this is about how you load with the direct delta. Okay. Now point here is so this is how it is. Now next, when it comes to setup tables, yeah. When you say you are deleting setup tables, are you deleting it for one application or one data source? One application. When you are running statical setup, did you specify for header data source or item data source, or are you just running it? When you are running statical setup here, did you ever specify only for header? It just says statical setup for old documents, orders. But does it say header or item or schedule? All the levels are field bus. So it will enter. Now look at this. Now what you see is cluster table, right? Actually, this cluster setup tables are in SAP ECC. You will have 3 types of tables: transparent tables, cluster tables, pool tables, and 3 types actually. Like in S11, what are the tables you've been working with? They are normal tables, transparent tables. But apart from transparent, we have something called క్లస్టర్ టేబుల్స్, పూల్ టేబుల్స్ అని కూడా ఉంటాయన్నమాట. నౌ దిస్ సెటప్ టేబుల్స్ ఆర్ ఇంప్లిమెంటెడ్ విత్ ద కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ క్లస్టర్ టేబుల్స్. నౌ లుక్ దిస్, క్లస్టర్ టేబుల్స్ ఎలా ఉంటాయి లుక్ దిస్. ఇన్ ద డేటాబేస్ లేయర్ యు విల్ హావ్ వన్ టేబుల్ ఫర్ ది ఎంటైర్ అప్లికేషన్, ఆల్ ద సేల్స్ ఆఫ్ హెడ్డర్ ఐటమ్, ఎంటైర్ డేటా స్టోర్డ్ ఇన్ సింగిల్ టేబుల్ అండ్ ఇన్ ద డేటాబేస్. ఓకే, బట్ ఇన్ అప్లికేషన్ లేయర్ ఇన్ S11 యూ విల్ సీ హెడ్డర్ డేటా సపరేట్ టేబుల్, ఐటమ్ సపరేట్ టేబుల్, హెడ్డర్ సపరేట్ టేబుల్. యూ రిమెంబర్ MC11 BA0 HDR SCTUP, I was able to see header in separate table. Yes sir, item in separate tables, right? But ultimately in the back end it is all stored in what? Single table. That's why when you delete or fill setup tables, it is all for entire application, cannot fill it for one level. When you delete the setup tables or when you fill the setup tables, it is all for entire application. All the levels of data is filled, not one. Why? That's why it is handled like this. So even though data is filled for the entire application, it has to differentiate for each level of data, because I have each data source for different level. I have got one data source for header, one data source for item, one data source for schedule line. So even though historical data is filled for entire application level, I need to differentiate with header, item and schedule line source. That's where it is this concept of setup tables now. In the database it is a single table, but in the application the content of this table can be seen in multiple smaller tables. We call this table cluster and these are cluster tables. Clear on this? Ila untundi back end line, actually. Okay. And the delta Q, understand now delta and delta repeat. So whenever you do any posting, it actually made us two sets, delta and delta repeat. When you do delta load, it fetches records from where? From delta. And it cleans up. But the records in the delta repeat will still stay back until next delta is successful. With that, we are able to handle the delta load failures by running repeat delta. When you run the repeat delta, when delta load fails, it brings in present delta records plus previous delta records also. So that is all the delta failures is all handled by the repeat delta management from delta. We also call delta case central delta management and current. So if someone asks you about can you please explain direct delta update, how does it work? We should explain like this. During the cutover activities, we schedule the downtime and then lock all the users and made sure that there is no new posting happening in the table. Then we have configured the statical setup job and collected all the data in setup tables, and then schedule the reload in BW, which will collect data from setup tables to what? BW. Then the data source was enabled for delta queue, delta capturing. Then from the next day when the postings were done, we were able to capture all the delta records into what? Delta queue, which was able to store both delta and what? Delta repetition. In BW, regularly we have scheduled the delta loads. And then don't tell him after doing init, go to VA01 post, don't tell that. I am just posting that to show you how the delta records have been extracted. Just schedule the downtime, delete your setup tables, fill your setup tables, run the neat load in BW, and the data source enabled for delta, then schedule the delta load in BW. That's it. So your steps would be, except this step, it is all same. Schedule the downtime, log the users, delete your setup tables, run the statical setup, then what? Schedule the neat load, then remove the users, unlock the users, then what? Schedule the delta load. In the steps it is, but for you and to understand, I've done the posting. Okay, boss? Yeah? So again, I'm going to clean up all this data. So this is what I showed you with what? With what? What update? Direct update. Do you know how to cancel the init? What is run? because I just want to cancel it out and rerun in it again with different update mode. Show you those update mode steps. Yeah. So I'm going to change this data source definition now. I'll go to what? Where to customize? LBWE. I'll inactivate the data source. I want, remember my before image was coming as positive for net value. Yeah. This is because of this. So now what I want, when I do some postings, whenever I do some change to the net value, I want it as before and after, right? For net value, enable this checkbox. You'll have checkbox on what? What is this? Inversion. The purpose of, if you enable this checkbox inversion, for this keyword, the before image value will be multiplied with minus 1 and then loaded into BW. Till delta Q it is positive, but by the time it enters into BW, it comes with into minus 1. Yeah? Now this time I want to go with what update mode? I'm going with what? Unserialized with the update now. You read those theory. And then what I'll see. Activate data source. Then I want to replicate the data source. I can replicate from here also. Right click and say replicate metadata source. Now I will have to do set data flow now. Again start the loading with, what was it? Unserialized with REPL. This is it. Now look at this. See, bringing of historical data is all same. No issues. Initial static setup, initial load is all same. But when it comes to delta records, now look at this. Now when the end user does a posting of the delta records, it's not collected to delta Q directly. All the delta postings will be collected to something called, what is this here? Update Q, SM13. Then look at this. Now what I do something here, what is here? V3 job. Then what I'll do to collect the records from update Q to delta Q, we schedule something called V3 job. Then in BW, when you do delta, it come from there, it's constantly same again. Delta Q, again, delta, delta replacement, delta load, delta repeat, it's all. Only change is, for the delta new postings, it does not collect into delta Q directly. It actually collects into what? Update Q, SM13. And when you schedule the V3 job, it collects from update Q to what? Delta Q. So, and then from here, it's not normal again. Delta Q will hold delta, delta replacement, it's all same concept again. So only the new step is what? V3 job. Okay, see, now let me do this. Now can I start doing this steps again? You schedule the downtime, then what? We delete the setup tables. We run the static setup. I don't want for everything, I just want only for these records. RMCVNUA, that's job name. D done. The job is done now. Should I see dead and syrup tables? So actually, can I say this is a syrup table for enter? So now can go back to what? Can I go back to BW and do what? Again, delta is cancelled. Tiller is no same steps, no difference. Okay, loaded, that's fine. Next, what I'll do, let's say we have released the locks and into the started doing postings. Now where does it VA 02, let's say it's changing some 7724, remove this value 5229. Okay, 5000 6000. Okay, let's say it's changing one more tag. Done, two postings. No, now will these postings be collected to delta Q directly? What did it say? Zero. Why? So we are working out with which update mode? Unserialized V3 update. So it does not collect them in delta Q directly. It will be in what? Update view. What is the P code? When you go to SF13 execute, you can see those records. The two all records, okay. Now if I get into any of this, select this MCX update queue, set display. Now go to which one it is? Header, right? Collect, double click on this header, you get to see the record. 7724 before after, you can see this. If you see the next one, so do you see those? Four records and two LAWs here. Here each entry is one LAW. Do you have a date and time here? Okay, boss. Now it has to extract all the entries from update queue to what? To delta queue. When does this happen? When you run the V3 job, boss. Generally in the real, we can run the V3 job here. Go to LAPWE for application level. Right? There is a link. What is the link here? We use this job control link to run the V3 job, but in the real time they don't do like that. I can just click on this job control link and say schedule job all this straight away. But in the real time they don't do like, because in the production environment you will not have access to this LPWE every time. First time they'll have, but not every time. So I will not be able to control. Then what they do is they create their, they know even when I trigger a job here, it is going to run some program. They'll catch that program and create their own job actually. I can see that program. RM star V3. RM BW Judani. This is a name. RM BW V3 and 2, 3, 4, 11, 2, 8. You'll have one program for each different application. For our sales order, you'll have one job. One program, delivery for everything. It's for 11, what is the program name? RMBW V3, and then what? 11. This is my program name. If I just, I can just run this program to collect entries from update queue, but I don't do this every day manually. I want to trigger this automatically in the background. In the V3 job, see, my delta load will be running automatically, right? And I want V3 job also to run automatically. I don't do manual process. Yeah. So for that, what I'll do? I'll take this program, create my own job. Where do you create? SM37 to monitor, and to create new job, SM36. ZV3 job daily sales. Okay, fine. And then it's a step. Give your ABAP program, give the program name. That should save. So for this, in this job now I place a program now, start condition immediate I want run, but in the real time you will schedule it periodically to run every daily once, but now I am just saying save. Now job is running. So where can I see the status of the job? SL. What is my, this one, ZV3 job daily sales, is my job done? If the V3 job is successfully done, if I go to SM13, will I have entries? No. Now where should I have entries now? Now if you go to RSS7, you see 11 HD, you see 1 here. Actually you should see what, 2 right, but it says 1. Here, in case of unserialized V3 update, 1 indicates 1 segment, 1 batch, all the 2 LTPs are set as what, 1 batch. I can see those entries. Now from here it's common again. Delta update will have two sets. Okay. See 2-5, 2-4 bus. From here again it's again common. Delta, delta page. Now I go back to BW, then what? Four regards have been brought. Now we'll understand the correct values now. See, now you see negative, it was 529, 5229, and then 5229 minus, and then it is what? Let's add, then you will see the correct values matching. Look at this, 7724, 5229, 5229 minus will get cancelled out, and the value is what? 6723. Now what is value in R3? 6723. And this was not coming as negative because the checkbox was not enabled universal. Then later I enabled, so it comes as negative. This is now do we run the V3 job manual or we'll schedule it daily bus? Daily early morning like 2 o'clock my V3 job would run in at 7 o'clock morning my delta would run. So which should run first? V3 job should run first or delta load should run first? V3 job should run. This is unserialized V3 update. Going on, no?